Welcome to the Prayer Motivator devotional broadcast with Daniel Whyte III. We are glad that you have joined us as Daniel Whyte III motivates us and encourages us to simply just pray for the glory of God. Daniel Whyte III is the national best-selling author of over 20 books. He has spoken in meetings across the United States and in over 25 foreign countries. He is the president of Gospel Light Society and Torch Ministries International. Now here's your host, Daniel Whyte III.
Welcome to another Prayer Motivator devotional broadcast, number 377. As always, it is so good to be with you today, to encourage you to pray. Today I would like to begin, as I always do, by sharing with you a poem on prayer. The title of this poem is Pray It Through by Daniel Whyte. Do you have a burden that you cannot bear? Do you have a sickness, a worry, or a care? Have you been to the throne for God to answer you? Have you prayed? Have you prayed it through? When everything seems to be going wrong and the hosts of hell around you throng, do you head to the throne for God to answer you? Do you pray? Do you pray it through? Do you believe in the Lord's good promise? Or does your faith falter like doubting Thomas when the one on the throne says he'll answer you if you'll pray, if you'll pray it through? When the rain and thunder brings morning dew, and the winds and waves settle that once blew, do you thank the Lord that he answered you because you prayed it through? Ladies and gentlemen, our prayer motivator verse from the Word of God today is Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 through 13. Which reads, After this manner, therefore pray ye, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to share with you some important insights regarding this passage from Matthew Henry's commentary. We must address him as our Father, he says, and must call him so. He is a common father to all mankind by creation. He is in a special manner a father to the saints by adoption and regeneration, and an unspeakable privilege it is. Thus we must see him in prayer, keep up good thoughts of him such as are encouraging and not affrighting. There is nothing more pleasing to God nor pleasant to ourselves than to call God Father. Christ in prayer mostly called God Father. If he be our Father, he will pity us under our weaknesses and infirmities, will spare us, will make the best of our performances, though very defective. Amen. Will deny us nothing that is good for us, will have access with boldness to him. We have access with boldness to him as to a father, and have an advocate with the Father and the Spirit of adoption. When we come repenting of our sins, we must eye God as a father, as the prodigal did. When we come begging for grace and peace and the inheritance and blessing of sons, it is an encouragement that we come to God, not as an unreconciled, avenging judge, but as a loving, gracious, reconciled Father in Christ. Right where you are to give God a shout, amen. We will discuss this verse further, this passage further in our next broadcast, if the Lord should tarry his coming and we live. Ladies and gentlemen, my personal encouragement to you today is that I believe it is a crime for husbands to leave home each morning, husbands and fathers, and not pray with their family. Why? Because as far as I am concerned, you leave your family unprotected against the attacks of the devil. I thank God for good godly women, but I have found out that many Christian women will not pray as much as they should if that man is not leading in prayer. Why? Because God has put something in that woman to really want to follow her husband, particularly in the matter of prayer, which can be very difficult at times. The Christ in her wants to follow her husband. And so, husbands, you have to lead in the spiritual discipline of prayer. Husbands and fathers, you not only have to pray for your family, you also have to pray with your family. Wives, you need to pray for your husband, and you both must pray with and for your children. This is not up for discussion. This must be done. Ladies and gentlemen, our prayer motivator quote today is from David Bryant. He said, "To pray in Jesus' name is to pray for something as it relates to his concerns, his cause, and his redemptive work as mediator in the gap. Even your most personal concerns should be related to the full scope of God's great plan for all nations. This may change what you ask for, why you ask for it, and what kinds of answers you expect, and what you will do when the answers come." Our prayer motivator devotional today is part 8 of our series titled, "Does God Work Miracles Today?" From that great prince of prayer, Dr. John R. Rice, my dear brother, who's in heaven right now, and I believe he's smiling down upon his dear brother in Christ. The night before Jesus was crucified, he wrote in the upper room, he was talking to the saddened disciples, and he gave them there the marvelous promise of John 14:12-14. "Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also, and greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it." This promise certainly involves miracles. The work that Jesus had been doing, these disciples should do too. But Jesus did not give the promise to the disciples only. Rather, the promise is to he that believeth on me. Anybody who has enough faith in Christ can do his work. The same kind of work that Jesus had been doing. Then Jesus continued his blessed promise addressed to the disciples, but evidently intended for everyone, and "whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that will I do." That whatsoever must involve things reaching into the supernatural, things that could be done only by the miracle working power of God. And verse 14 says, "If ye shall ask anything in my name, I will do it." Anything means anything. You can put anything in the place of the word anything, And the promise is still literally true, and exactly what Jesus meant. You could read that promise, "If ye shall ask a miracle in my name, I will do it." And still you would not have changed the meaning. Anything means anything. And a miracle is a thing coming within this blessed promise. Certainly, then, the Savior promised miracles to those who ask things purely in his name. That is, when one can ask a thing wholly in Jesus' name or with his authority, and for his sake, with his approval, then one can get it, even if it be a miracle. Now, friend, it is time for us to pray for our miracle and to pray for our anything. Please remember, the announcer will provide the information for you to send in your prayer request at the end of this broadcast. Holy Father God, we love you because you first loved us. We thank you for your grace and for your love. And Lord, help us to understand that if we truly love you, we would keep your commandments. Lord, we confess our sins, our disobedience, our rebelliousness, our not keeping your commandments as we should. Wash and cleanse our hearts, minds, souls, spirits, and consciences in the blood of Christ from all sin and from all unrighteousness. Lord, we pray that you'd crucify our flesh and fill us afresh and anew with the fullness and the power of your Holy Spirit. Lead us, guide us, and direct us in the way that you'd have us to go throughout this day. Order our steps and direct our ways. Lord, we also pray today for every pastor, every evangelist, every missionary, every church leader around the globe who stands for you and who loves your people and who are truly helping your people. Lord, we pray for the healing of every Christian marriage and family in the world. We pray for every wayward teenager, every wayward wife, every wayward husband. Lord, rebuke and bind the devil from them, from their family, and heal their marriage and family. Lord, we pray for the revival of your church. We pray for repentance in your church. We pray, Lord, for the salvation of over 3 million people through this ministry alone. And Holy Father God, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the salvation of millions more in other ministries as well. Lord, we pray for the healing of this nation. And we pray for a spiritual awakening to take place in this nation. Lord, we pray that you'd give us the leadership that we need going forward in this country. We pray also that you would save and give leadership, guidance, direction, and wisdom to the president and to all governmental officials who run this country. Save their souls. Cast the devil and demons of hell from their lives. Lord, we pray for all of the governmental officials in other countries as well. We pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Now, Lord, we pray for 3 people who have sent in prayer requests to our ministry here at Gospel Light Society. We pray for Lynn in Hazel Green, Kentucky. Help her fiancé to have faith and believe that they will get a home for their children. Lord, we pray for Andrew in Nairobi, Kenya. Bless him with finances and success in his education. We pray that prayer for all Christians who are trying to gain more education and to learn how to do new things around the globe. We pray, Lord, for Brother Johnson in Accra, Ghana. Strengthen his relationship with you and use him in a big way. Help him to serve you with all of his heart, soul, and mind. Holy Father God, we pray for the following people who have accepted you into their hearts. We pray, Lord, that you would strengthen them in the faith and have them to grow in the faith, to become the strong, spirit-filled Christians that you want them to be. We pray specifically for Blanca in New York, Uche in Abuja, Nigeria, and we pray for all of our brothers and sisters in Christ in Nigeria who are under persecution. Protect them and keep them and prepare them. Lord, we also pray for Adinaka in Ajuna, Abukpa. And Lord, we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for them. Help them to find good Bible-believing churches to grow in as well in their area. Lord, help us to do our part in discipling them and loving on them as well. Now, Lord, we pray for the following people who have been saved for a while, but who have recommitted their lives to you. We rejoice with them in this decision and pray that they will keep their commitments to you and be strengthened in the faith. We pray specifically for Carla in Jacksonville, Florida, Mary in Kumasi, Ghana, Shinyir in Abia State, Nigeria. We pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we commit these souls into your hands. Let your will be done in their lives. In Jesus Christ's name we pray, and for his sake, amen. Now, dear friend, if you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, please allow me to show you how you can get to know him today. All you have to do is believe that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. And like millions of others, you can come to know the risen Lord Jesus Christ for yourself. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life." The Bible states in the book of Romans 10:9-13 that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou you shall be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. If you are willing right now to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ for your salvation, please pray with me the following simple prayer. Holy Father God, I realize that I am a sinner and that I have done some bad things in my life. For Jesus Christ's sake, please forgive me of all of my sins. I now believe with all of my heart that Jesus Christ died for me, was buried, and rose again. Lord Jesus, please come into my heart and save my soul and change my life today and forever. Amen. If you just trusted Jesus Christ as your Savior and you prayed that prayer, meant it from your heart, I declare to you that based upon the Word of God, you are now saved from hell and you are on your way to heaven. I want to congratulate you on doing the most important thing in life, and that is receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. For more information to help you grow in your newfound faith in Christ, go to GospelLightSociety.com and read what to do after you enter through the door. Until next time, my beloved, please remember, pray, think, do. God bless you.
Thank you for listening to the Prayer Motivator devotional broadcast with Daniel Whyte III. If you would like for us to pray for you, please send your prayer request to gls@gospellightsociety.com. If you have questions about salvation, what to do after salvation, are looking for a good church home, or would like to read our pamphlet, What to Do After You Enter Through the Door, please visit GospelLightSociety.com for more information. This radio broadcast can be heard daily on GospelLightWorldRadio.com, Live 365, BCNN Radio 7.com, and on our Spanish station, EvangelioLasMundoRadio.com. It can also be downloaded on your iPhone, BlackBerry, Android, or other mobile device from iTunes, Google Play, BlackBerry Podcast, and other outlets. Tell your friends and family to tune in and discover the power of prayer. Now here's a song that will encourage you to pray. God bless.
start somewhere, why not here? If you gotta start sometime, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now. Love will fall to the earth like a crashing wave. Tonight's the night for the sinners and the saints. Two worlds collide in a beautiful display. It's all love tonight. When we step across the line, we can sail across the sea to a city. Start somewhere, why not here? If you gotta start sometime, why not now? If we gotta start somewhere, I say here. If we gotta start sometime, I say now. Through the fog, there is hope in the distance. From cathedrals to third world. Love will fall to the earth like a crashing wave. Tonight's the night for the sinners and the saints. Two worlds collide in a beautiful display. It's all love tonight. When we step across the line, we can sail across the sea to a city with one king. If we gotta start sometime, why not now?